subscribe right now and press the bell icon for more videos.
Sahabi Rasul, Hazrat Abdullah ibn Jahsh radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He is one of the early Muslim. He was one of the wealthy Sahaba. He has a very beautiful house in Makkah. The house was very expensive. It was famous all over there, and it was very precious to him and his family. Hazrat Abdullah ibn Jahsh loved his house, his land, and that house loved him too. It was his property. Hazrat Abdullah ibn Jahsh was one of the fortunate ones because his whole family embraced Islam in the early days. By the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, and through Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Otherwise, it was only the family members who mostly tortured their relatives, their close ones. And as I mentioned the torture, as soon as enemies and mushrikeen found out that Ibn Jahsh and his family had accepted Islam, they started to oppress them. They started to torture him, and the clouds of hardship have covered their home. Their lives have become miserable because of Kufare Makkah, or because of Kufare Quraysh. Ibn Jahsh and his family patiently stood against the persecution and did not give up on Iman, on Islam. And after some year, Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam gave him permission to emigrate to Madinah to avoid further persecution from the enemy. Hijrah was itself a life and death step. Some member of his family had already migrated before to Abyssinia. This time, however, his migration was far bigger scale. His family, relatives, men, women, children migrated with him. In fact, his whole clan had become Muslim and accompanied him. And as they left Makkah, their home appeared sad and depressed, as if no one had lived there before. The whole atmosphere was full of loneliness, no sound of conversation coming from behind those silent walls. Ibn Jahsh clan was not long gone. This alerted Quraysh leaders. They came out and made the round of the district in Makkah. They found out that Jahsh clan has able to escape Utbah ibn Rabia and Abu Jahl approached the house. Then Utbah looked at the house of the Banu Jahsh, through which the dusty winds were blowing. Then he came forward and banged on the door and shouted, "The house of Banu Jahsh have become empty and are weeping for its occupants." Then Abu Jahl indecisively said, "Who were these people anyway? That houses should weep for them." Then Utbah and Abu Jahl steal the house and the property of Ibn Jahsh and his family. Abu Jahl then laid claim to the house of Abdullah ibn Jahsh radiallahu ta'ala anhu. First, Ibn Jahsh and his family were forced to leave their land and home. Then that house of theirs was taken away from them, was stolen away from them, never to return it. They lost their house forever. Meanwhile, Hazrat Abdullah ibn Jahsh and his family were able to reach Madinah safely. And later on, when Hazrat Abdullah ibn Jahsh heard what Abu Jahl has done to his house, his property, he became very, very sad to hear this news. In sadness, he went and mentioned this to Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, who said, "Aren't you satisfied, O Abdullah, with what Allah has given to you? Insert a house in the Jannah, in the paradise." "Yes, I am, Messenger of Allah," he replied. Immediately after hearing this sweet line, His all tension and sadness was replaced by a peace of mind. The love of that house, of that land, just vanished, and now he was completely satisfied. Why? Because his faith in Allah was too strong. His love for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was too strong, and he has a strong iman and faith. And this was just the beginning of blessing and honor and glory which the future holds for Hazrat Abdullah ibn Jahsh and his family. Subhanallah, Subhanallah. Now, I want to ask a question to my viewer, to my listener. Do you hold any property which is dear to you? Is there any property of your or a thing which you love the most? Because I want to tell you a very special thing today. Do you know which is the best and great property for a believer, for a mu'min? Yes, there is a property for every believer which is lost, unfortunately, today. And that lost property of a mu'min is mentioned in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And I personally just love this hadith. When first time I read it, I just get motivated and I used to read it again and again. Now allow me to present this hadith to you. Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wasallam said, "The word of wisdom is the lost property of the believer. Whenever he finds it, he is most deserving of it. I feel blessed because my religion is Islam, who encouraged me to earn the knowledge. I feel blessed that wisdom is growing inside and outside me by the favor of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I feel blessed because the book that I follow is glorious Quran and no book can match it. I feel blessed because my property of wisdom will stay with me in this world as well as in grave and hereafter, and no one gonna steal it.